goes by the name of Ice Burgandy. Ice, what's going on with you, fam?
What you got going?
Ain't nothing to it, man. We out here grinding, man. You know, getting that good grinding, man. But what's going on with you, man? I hit a new single. You got a new single out now, right?
Yeah, with YC, with Young Chris.
Right, you got a new single out with YC. What's the name of the single?
How You Want It.
Right, how you want it. Now, it's not necessarily how I want it, you're asking. You want to know
Nah.
Okay, good. I'm just making sure you're not a disco dancer, my nigga. All right.
Nah.
So you want to know how the female wants it.
Exactly.
Okay, there you go. So what brought on this song, man? Because I didn't, you know, listening to some of your previous music, I didn't really see this type of single coming. You know, you kind of hit niggas by surprise with this one.
Well, you know, I got two sides. I got gang side, I got a side for the ladies. I got a new mixtape that's going to come out 2017 called Rhythm and Burgundy. So you're going to hear more shit like that on there.
Oh, okay, there you go. But you don't have a third, you know, there's no disco dancer side, right?
Alright,
so that's what it is. So you have a new single out. You have a new mixtape that you're getting ready to release. Mm-hmm. Right? And you're still rolling with Brick Squad Monopoly, correct?
Yep, Squad.
Now, how long have you been down with the squad?
A little bit over a year now.
Now, how did the whole situation come about? I know it had something to do with Waka Flocka, correct?
Yeah, when Waka came to Cali to do that Hard in the Paint video.
Right.
I met up with him. I pushed up over there on the location and shit and chopped it up. Then the next day, he was in the studio and Shit Knight called me down. And I came up there and did that song. And I ended up being on his album. Then he called me back like a month later. When y'all like, yeah, I'm gonna put that on the album or fuck with you. Let's get it.
Now,
hell yeah, let's do it.
Now, how in the hell did Suge Knight end up calling me? What the hell happened there?
Oh, well, you know, I fucks with Suge. I be in these streets. I be thugging with him. And he just, he know I be on one. So he called me like, what's up? We'll come up with your studio. Chill. So
okay.
I was up there chilling with them. And, you know, me and Waffle got this. Holler some money. He's like, you rap? I'm like, yeah, I know. I can rap. He's like, put a verse on this. And
Okay.
All right. History,
and so. Everything else from there is history. And now, since then, you've been featured on actually a few of Waka's albums, correct? I know you was on Flocka Valley. What else did you do?
On Gucci Mane and Waka's other album, Ferrari Boys.
You've also been known for, sadly, for a controversial issue that happened with a game out there on the West Coast.
Yeah,
correct.
Yeah,
now,
that's me too.
Right. Now, initially, the whole game beef started over what? It was a Twitter comment, and I read the comment. It didn't even sound like he was trying to get at the nigga.
I definitely wasn't trying to get at the nigga, and this shit's big, all right? I really wasn't trying to get at the nigga. I just spoke on how I felt. It wasn't really nothing like that to be beefing, though. He said his words, cool, whatever. And then, you know, some outside parties looking in. He know both sides, so he calls that side. First, he tried to call me, but my phone was going to voicemail. It was dead. So he called the other side. Then he called my other homeboy. I said, what game in Burgundy? I seen him going back and forth on Twitter. I'm like, oh, yeah. They said some shit. It ain't nothing. He like, yeah, I just called Whoopi Whoop, and game in the back star talking about he gonna knock him out when he see him.
Right.
So that's how that whole shit starts. For real? Okay.
Now,
Now
the thing is, and look, you know, I've had my little issues with Game, but nothing serious. I really do think he's a talented artist, man.
Oh, for sure, he can rap.
Why is he hated so much on that goddamn coast? It seems like everybody has beef with this nigga, man.
Because he trying to be something that he's not. He needs to just stick to rap. Like, he's a hell of a rapper, but when it comes to that other shit, he ain't nothing.
Right.
Over here.
And recently, he allegedly got into something with 40 Glock.
Yeah, where they drew down on him and jumped him and shit.
Right, and that's my homie. We'll see what happens with that, man. I don't think that situation is over, but it definitely is what it is. Now, in the midst of that whole situation, you actually lost a soldier. Was it due to that situation, or was it due to something else?
No, that was due to something else.
That was due to something totally different. So there was no correlation to Rosemo being murdered with that situation.
Nah, hell nah.
Okay, so they
was on some whole other street shit. My boy Rosemo, he was out here in these streets turned up. You feel me? A lot of people didn't like him either. You feel me?
Right. Because, I see a lot of comments, and I know there's a lot of misconception around, especially when people are in the public eye, and even when you're dealing with internet media, it's still the public eye. Yeah, and when, you know, the homie was known for one thing, which was basically knocking out Game, and then, you know, a little while after that, he's killed, people automatically assume that the reason why he was killed was due to, you know, the situation with Game.
I can see how it looked like that. But if people really pay close attention, there's a whole lot of other shit going on too. So
yeah,
that was nothing. That was just coincidental.
Right. Now you're keeping your name clear out of that stuff too, though.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And anything else harsh going on with Game, or have you cleared, you know, rectified that situation?
No. Ain't nothing clear to rectify. Nothing. I ain't seen Lane ran across him since then.
So it's still not rectified. So if you run across them, there's, you know, possibly going to be still more problems.
Yeah, ain't no telling what's going to happen.
Well, my nigga Game, shit. You know, this nigga been on a goddamn move, nigga. Lace them Chuck Taylors up, because niggas is coming for this nigga out there, man. All right.
Yeah, well, you guys, you know, niggas going to come for you. Like me, I don't even have to tell a nigga to come for you. These streets, they fuck with me. So when they feel like a nigga trying to fuck with me or something like that, or disrespected, they gonna move, whether I say so or not.
Now, the situation the first time when you got into it, you didn't jump him or anything like that. Knocked him out.
Head up, my guy acted. Shit happened how it happened.
All right, well, listen, it is what it is, man. We're gonna move past that situation. We're gonna move into, you know what I mean, what's going on in the present. Now, once again, you have the new single bubbling. It's called How You Want It. Right,
mm-hmm.
you're pushing this single hard. Now, is there gonna be a video to this single being done anytime soon or what?
Yeah. We're gonna shoot that. I gotta get back on the road and hit Atlanta and go grab my boy YC so we can do this shit.
Right.
Most definitely look out for a video coming soon.
Now, listen. Now is there any other artists, West Coast artists in specific, that you want to work with that you haven't worked with yet, man?
That I want to work with, besides like the legends or something.
Well, whoever you want to work with, my nigga Snoop Lion.
Yeah, I wouldn't have no problem working with Snoop. You know, it's West Coast legend, Snoop.
Yeah, you gotta.
G.
You gotta change your name to Lion though, if you fuck with my nigga Snoop.
You gotta change your name to Lion.
Yeah.
Why you say that?
You didn't hear?
Huh?
My nigga Snoop changed his name.
To what?
Snoop Lion.
Snoop Lion.
Yeah.
He's doing a reggae album.
No. He said he no longer wants to be called Snoop Dogg. He wants to be called Snoop Lion. The nigga said he had a conversation with Bob Marley, and he spoke to him, and now he wants to reevaluate his outlook on life.
He's just smoking too much of that ganja. That's all that
and
is.
And change his name to Snoop Lion.
For real. Yeah, he was high as a motherfucker.
Exactly. I'm glad you agree with me.
But any other artists, any other up and coming West Coast artists you want to fuck with?
Not really no one. I mean, if it happens, it happens. But you know, I really don't even be listening to nobody on the West Coast really like that. Besides like the people that I already got music with. So
yeah, why don't you West Coast artists fuck with each other? It seems like nobody on the West Coast fucks with nobody else on the West Coast.
It's just our politics, our upbringings with the gangs and the shit, the hoods, everybody like. Stick to theyself, you know.
I definitely can't knock it. What do you feel about, you know, the other hip hop out there? Because the track that you put out, it has a southern feel, and I know you fucking with the niggas in the south heavy, but it definitely doesn't have that West Coast feel at all.
Well, like I tell you, I don't listen to West Coast. Like, I grew up on Snoop and them, but shit, they not rapping the same shit I grew up on really anymore. So I ain't really listening to them. I ain't checking for them today or nothing like that. Like, the niggas I listen to from down south.
Baby, you the baddest, let me show it. Just looking at your ass, all this cash, I'ma throw it. I put